I'm just out for my morning walk, and I mean to tell you, that is a big snake. That is a big snake. We're up in North Carolina. And I'm shooting with my cell phone, so I don't know how that shows up, but that is a dark black snake. That is 4 feet long. And like most snakes, I just came around, I was gonna do a little yard work, and I just kinda actually walked by him once already, and I turned around and come back, and he's there. He's their first line of defense is to just freeze, and he is frozen. And his philosophy is, if I don't see him, he's happy. Now, he's obviously not poisonous. He's not a black racer. I'm not sure what he is. He's a pretty one. Very pretty, actually. I don't know how well you can see him down there. He is gorgeous. She or she, probably a she. That, my friends, is a big snake. And the thing you don't want to do with a snake like that is kill it. He is pretty. Now, I've seen this same behavior even from rattlesnakes. And there's Freeze, man. He is not moving an inch. What's interesting about this guy is, and he's got all these little bends, and he's got like dozens of little bends. All the way out to his tail there. I'm actually blocking the sun there. So, you are beautiful. I have never seen a snake be this. Never seen a snake be this still before. He is gorgeous. Unfortunately, there's a little, I'm going to take a little chance here. Let's try and get a look at his face. He's simply not going to move. Now we can see you. Now, because of the way he is, he's out flailing. There's absolutely no way that he can strike. Of course, he's not, obviously not poisonous either. But he's just all stretched out. And now he's deciding, maybe I should leave. Go ahead, buddy. He's He's been putting up with me for a while. Go. Go ahead. I'm going to touch him a little bit in the back here. There we go. You just move on. Go ahead. That is a heavy snake. What I'm doing is I'm reaching with a stick and go ahead. Oh, what a beautiful snake. What a beauty. That is beautiful. That's no black racer. You just watch him go by. That is one big snake. Consider our blessings to see him pass by. See, that is what's so cool. He knows I'm right here. It'd be very easy to kill this dude. I'm just gonna watch him go by inch by inch. Another foot or two and we'll see his tail. There you go. That's what we call a snake in the grass. He's got his taking his good old time with it. There you go. Off he goes into the wilderness. It's one reason why I always wear heavy shoes when I'm doing yard work, but he's back in there. That's kind of interesting. I've been doing some work in the yard, and that snake is, I've ran into him again. He's, I'm not sure exactly where he's going, but you can see where he is back in there. He moved into the wood, now he's coming back. I guess there's a wetter in the back. He's heading back there, but here you can see him. And he's a slow motion guy. He's a patiently stalks whatever he's after. Most of the time they're gonna eat, well, probably mice. I think mice and other small critters would be his main diet. But I'm trying to leave him alone, but he's back in my way again. He's just going to take his time. Non-poisonous snake, and it's sad that there you see him moving. He's moving so slow, you can almost imperceptible. But once he gets back in the grass and the leaf litter and in the forest, you're just not going to see him. It's funny, you know, you worry about timber rattlesnakes up here in the mountains. And this is the biggest snake I've seen. I've ran into timber rattlesnakes, but I was talking to a guy that used to be a, you know, he's going right across the path there. I'll be darned. He's just taking his good old time there. Reminds me, I was talking to a guy that used to be a, Keep going there, buddy. We ain't gonna bother you. Go ahead. My goodness. You're a sight to behold. We have black racers in Florida are kind of similar, but they're a little shinier. This one's got a lot more texture to it and more like an indigo snake, although it's not an indigo snake, but black racer just runs like crazy. This guy is, of course, much bigger than a black racer, and a snake this big just can't move that fast. And now that I see him out in the open here, he's 5 feet long. That's amazing. That snake is 5 feet long. But I was talking to he's just going down the trail, actually, which makes sense to me. Keep going, old timer. We're gonna take a walk with a snake. This is a little different, I gotta say. He's got a real fat midsection there. So I wouldn't be surprised if he had something to eat not too long ago. But I was talking to a guy that used to be a ranger in the Park Service. I was telling him how I'm surprised that in all the years I've been up there, I've never seen a timber rattlesnake or a copperhead. And he says, people walk by him all the time and never see him. A copperhead, of course, mixed in with a leaf litter, you're just not going to see it. Only if you step directly on him are you likely to have a problem. Okay, well, turned a dull morning into an interesting morning.